is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. Of course, a special edition. And of course, it's special because I'm here. And of course, Fed Newt's out just before the show, the really big show started. Basically flat here on the S&P cash, which is what I was kind of looking for. My thoughts before anything came out was that we were going to have a flat day, and that as soon as everybody saw this, we'd be going right on to worrying about what's going to happen for earnings after the bell tonight. Some little movements around. I think some people were thinking that you get an instant move off of this one, and some people probably a little short here, a little long there. But, you know, other than maybe gold moving a little bit, I think it was up $3 or something last time I looked here during the break. But that's kind of it. We're just kind of marking time, at least I suspect, until we actually do see the last of what should be some of the big earnings. Volume has been light, but, you know, you're waiting for a few things, not particularly different. 5.2 billion shares, though, way below what we saw yesterday by, I don't know, 1.5 billion shares or so at this time. So pretty quiet on the Western front, not thinking that we do a lot again. We'd have to find something, I don't know, kind of like people rooting around in the Constitution, find something that isn't there to justify a decision that's probably bad. And only after years and years of finding out that it's bad do those folks say, well, maybe you didn't quite say that. But you never know. Anyway, light volume. Not much of a movement so far. I show down one on the S&P, NASDAQ's, is that right, 30? Probably. Yeah, plus 30. So, yeah, anything. In fact, I did have an email just before the show here that I will say, yes, not much of anything or not much movement is like maybe 0.2% up or down on the NASDAQ or the S&P is a rounding error. I never really spend that much time looking at the Dow. It's 30 stocks. Of those 30 stocks, they're 95% institutionally owned. There's only about 5% of the shares that can actually trade. So it's not a big indicator as far as I can see. Generally, it's almost always the tail wagging the dog on it. But if you can have about 350 stocks in a bigger index, you're probably going to be plus or minus 5% for it actually giving you some kind of significant signal, at least statistically. You know, I hear people quoting Dow on the news and stuff. It just doesn't do much for me because literally it's a fairly bad indication. We've got the S&P 500. That's a lot of the institutionally owned, but too big for any one person to really move around. The NASDAQ, of course, depends on which one you're looking at. But if you're talking about the big one, not the NASDAQ 100, you know, you've got a ton of stocks in that. It's kind of hard to move it around too much, although it is cap weighted. The NASDAQ 100, probably worthless. Six stocks make up 65% of everything in it. I think it's the last time I looked at it, it was 60% for the top six stocks. So, again, not worth a whole lot. So, anyway, we'll watch what's going on. Options have been pointing lower. We talked about that somewhat yesterday. Question is, do and are the option market makers correct? Generally, they are. If someone's going to know something, those people do, and they generally know that because most of those things are in the big houses. That means that they know where all the bodies are buried. They know where it's easy to move things in and out and scare people. They also know, you know, just what people are telling them. A lot of the big houses, of course, trade for those hedge funds, but that's about it. After the bell tonight, we've got NVIDIA and Cisco, and that's what everybody's kind of working for or thinking about, and that's about it. We'll let the dust settle, but I'm not expecting a whole lot of bounce in this market. As I said, I think all quiet on the Western front. We need something, what's a kind of surprise that most people didn't find or know about? You have to find something that really, has anything popped out like a letter in history that really changed people's view on something? I don't know. You know, occasionally you find a bunch of Bible scrolls out in the middle of the desert, but pretty much we all already knew everything that was in that. Not much different. I think that's about it. I'm looking at the Fed notes here as a bunch of scraps of stuff of the Bible that were pretty much already known. So I don't think there's going to be a lot here. One of the questions. I don't. Fixed one way. I think it's a connector. Don't think anything's going to happen. We got a couple of minutes here. Let's do a little bit of history, and then we'll come back from the break, and maybe some more dust has settled.
Then it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1991, Soviet President Mikhail Gorbachev, the man known for having something that looked like maybe a state, or maybe a country, as a big mark on his forehead. People thought it moved around a bit. People always thought, what did it actually mean? Where did it come from? It's hard to not look at that when you look at the guy. Anyway, he was placed under arrest during a coup by the high-ranking members of his own government, military, and police forces. Since becoming leader of the Soviet Union, USSR, for those folks in Lutz, Florida. In 1988, Gorbachev had pursued comprehensive reforms in the Soviet system, combining perestroika, restructuring of the economy, including a greater emphasis on free market policies, and glasnost, openness in diplomacy. Of course, all of this is in the backdrop of a couple of things that ran them bankrupt. First of all was Fukushima, but it's not the meltdown of the nuclear reactor in 1986. And, of course, spending a lot of money that they did not have in Afghanistan, with losing a great deal of blood and treasure, as it is known. In this day in 1991, a coup back.
Are you grinding in the market, but seeing little to no return? Or are you a successful trader, simply looking to make your job a little easier? Learn to take the path of least resistance with David White's powerful trading newsletter. David White is an accomplished trader whose deep understanding of technology and the markets allows him to consistently find and share winning trades. Support and resistance define the ranges in which stocks trade. By understanding these trading ranges, David White is able to find the path of least resistance. David White's trading newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, is delivered daily before the markets open to make every trading day an easy win. Visit TFNN.com today and subscribe to David White's Ultimate Trading Newsletter for $119 a month. And try all of our newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Take the path of least resistance at TFNN, educating investors.
What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right, information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TAS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE, and you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we had a little hiccup here, down 20 points on the S&P cash. Everybody thinks something happened. I looked, I can't find any kind of headline, but as we said yesterday, I was looking for kind of a flattish day. Maybe repairs itself before the end of the day. Who knows? But I'm thinking more weakness tomorrow and through Friday. That's basically what the option market makers are betting on. And I generally follow them at least through expiration. The rest of the time, you kind of have to figure it out by yourself. Okay, questions are ready about NVIDIA, NVDA. Of course, after the bell tonight, see what the question is here. What are your thoughts on NVIDIA, the report today? Do you also expect NVIDIA to join the Dow? I do not expect it to join the Dow. Here's the problem. There's a word that no one wants to hear, and all they have to do is say that in the liners or during the conference call, and it goes lower. And that's supply constraints. Everybody else has been in that sector, and right now everybody is actually thinking or in that sector. A lot of people are talking about it. When you see NVIDIA, you actually have a fairly good sell pattern out here. You had a lot of energy down from 208.75 on July 7th down to 178.66, excuse me. That is the July 19th low. When you came up, you had no energy. You got into the previous high that had 42 million shares with 21 million shares, and now you're sliding back down. Now, maybe it's all been a giant trap what's the guy's name? I can't remember his name now. It's a trap. I'll find it during the break. It could be a trap. But it's all about whether or not they start talking about supply constraints and or production constraints, since they use a great deal of two different manufacturers or fabricators, we'll call it that, but mostly heavily reliant on Taiwan Semiconductor. If they can't make the parts, then you don't make the money. And it's not a problem of actually, if you had the product, they could sell four times what they could sell this month easily, and maybe for a few months going on. So there could be a huge boom in this company, but it doesn't look like that's going to change. It's not that easy just to start making a bunch of parts. And of course, NVIDIA is not the only company pulling on them. Apple actually paid up huge to go after Taiwan Semiconductor. Do they come back and just say Apple is willing to throw any amount of money to make sure those parts came out and we weren't, and Taiwan Semi came and did it? But it's all about supply and manufacturing constraints. But mostly they'll be talking about supply as whether or not Taiwan Semiconductor can actually make it. And that's why it's kind of interesting to see what actual Taiwan Semiconductor has been doing. And that hasn't been good either. So the only thing is it has come back down. What you dislike is the big volume yesterday. They've got a low at 107.46. So that's part of it. And then you look at the rest of the semiconductor space, and it does not look that good. It's, you know, the SMH has topped out, had kind of a false break of around 263. 264, got to 271, 79 with no volume. They're coming back down. You did have a little bit of juice yesterday, call it 5.1 million shares. Don't have much in the way today. But 245 would be where this would come back down to. And that would just be a giant trading range between 245 and 271, although I think 263. 264 is really where the thing started breaking above and never had the juice. So we'll see as we move along. Admiral Akbar. Yes, I couldn't remember his name, but I do remember that he talked about being a trap a great deal. And I can't remember. Is it classic movies? It's a trap. It's a trap. Can't remember. Do I have it here? I got it somewhere. I'll find it. Anyway, other things going on here. That was the first question from Hector. Another question about SHOP. Do you think SHOP has a good chance to tag the high of 810? Shopify. High July 23rd was 1650. It's just been kind of going sideways out here. This was another one where you really wanted to see volume at the highs, somewhere around 3-4 million shares. You made a high. You never had the energy. You had about 1.4 million shares on July 23rd. It kind of came back into this trading range here. I don't know what they're going to say for earnings either. Kind of just sideways, but I very much dislike that it busted above and didn't get any volume, that it's kind of come back and looks more like distribution. But I wouldn't bet on that one way or the other. I think on NVIDIA, you can look for the words and you'll know how it's going to move fairly quickly. If they start seeing reduced sales, then everybody knows that supply constraints are still a problem. Shopify, not that big a deal. It's either, you know, it's probably just the earnings that will determine which way it goes. If they're good, then it goes higher. If they're low, it goes lower. And again, all these companies have the ability to massage their earnings for several quarters before it catches up to them. And that's why earnings are such a crapshoot. And that is that for many quarters, they can be, you know, not doing so well. And you just shove a little bit more numbers in this quarter and maybe next quarter and then the third quarter. And the reason you do that is you're a CEO and you don't want to get booted out. And Wall Street always, you're only as good as your last quarter, but by three quarters or maybe even four quarters, the jungle drums are out there beating for you to actually turn a bigger profit all the time. You always have analysts saying that you're going to do better and better. Eventually, they are wrong, and generally you get the big surprise. I would say that if you go higher, maybe you get $50 out of this. The downside is if you go lower, it's back down to about $12.50. So maybe they come in right down the center, but Shopify, a very tough call. We'll be back in.
Are you having fun trading the markets, but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Thinkorswim. For more information, just click the Thinkorswim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're back. And of course, as always, well, I guess I was right.
It's a trap.
Thank you, Admiral Akbar. Okay, what else do we have out here? You got to know your Star Wars if you listen to the show. Okay, other things going on here. Let's take a look, quick look at Micron, see if anything's going on there. As we talked about it, it had the what is probably a fairly good definition of an exhaustion move, and that is down to 68.81. You've now got 4 days of it going sideways inside that same candle. The only difference is zero in the way of volume. It hasn't broken above the 3x3 displaced moving average, so the trend is still intact, but we shall see. Like I said, I think a lot of these things are all loaded for whatever NVIDIA says. We didn't talk about Cisco so much. But it's gone higher. And of course, a great deal of that has been that you couldn't buy, or at least if you were in the West, you couldn't buy the discount routers that China was selling, because of course, all of them had not only software backdoors, but hardware backdoors inside them too. More calls over the last couple of days also. To look at anything that is owned by the Chi-Coms. If you're unfamiliar with your Cold War terminology, that is the Chinese communists, opposed to the Chinese in Taiwan, who are very much capitalists. Anyway, the Chi-Coms, of course, still running, TikTok, and a bunch of other ones. In fact, I saw a list yesterday, about all the ones that harvest, all the Chinese apps that harvest huge amounts of data for anybody that uses them, quite significantly a big deal. But I think the latest move on TikTok was that the Chinese government actually is a major owner of TikTok now. So what can you say about that? In fact, a great deal of more in the way of communist talk from the leader over the last couple of days, too. So for Cisco, as long as China continues to move in a way that they're just saying, well, you can suck it, we're going to steal as much data as we can, probably things are probably still rosy for Cisco without a lot of competitors who mostly are based in or around China for their discount routers. And there is quite the discount. A lot of the routers that do similar things to Cisco, their flagship, which is about $5,000 a piece, can be had for about $3,200 from China. So there is a discount if you're willing to pay the price of finding out that someone else has found out that backdoor, and suddenly the keys to the kingdom are instantly available. So Cisco is the one that if you get hacked, you're probably not get yelled at. Certainly if you continue to buy the Chinese versions of them, I would say that the chances of you getting hacked are about 100%, but that's it. Yeah, most made by Huawei, but there's a couple other companies out there, but significantly cheaper and almost a kind of a metaphor for the Trojan horse, right? To sell all your stuff, make it cheap, put everything you want in the back end of it, and you'll just steal all the secrets that everybody else has. Give me a call, 877-927-6648. And what do we have now? Down five. So we'll go right back to, is that right? Do I have it? Or did I miss it? Yeah, I did. But it certainly does look like
it's a trap.
It was a small trap. Anyway, 44.43 on the S&P cash. Again, I don't suspect we're going to have a lot of movement. Up 25 on the NASDAQ. There's always a little bit of rock and roll after these numbers. I didn't think that they were going to find much of anything out there. Next question comes from Kim, who wants to talk about AMD. Again, if you want a better view of AMD, it's all going to be about what NVIDIA says, because, of course, supply chains are about the same for them. They may give us a good heads up on their inventory of Micron chips, which might actually make Micron move more than AMD or NVIDIA after the bell tonight. So keep an eye on that. You don't have a lot of volume. You do have a lot of sideways. And the question is whether or not that's a low that you can look at. Certainly, you like the last, you like the low volume so far today, testing the lows about a week ago on the 10th. That 113 million shares, you got 60 million shares. Now, you did bust just below that. Actually, there's some fairly good volume just below. About a 103. So the low today at 103.78 is fairly close. Let's see what that is for a retracement. Okay. It just depends on which one you're looking at. Well, let's just look at the super parabolic one, and that is the 84.24 low of July 19th up to 122.49. That retracement is right where we're at now. 103.36 is the 50% retracement. We're dancing all over that along with the high volume up day of the, the 29th of July. So you've probably got some fairly decent support. But again, it's going to be all about the supply comments tonight from NVIDIA. See what else do we have here. Got a few more coming in. Question about Micron out here. So we'll take a look at that once again. Again, just sideways, light volume. Don't know if you can say anything about that. We looked at the SMHs. Question about Intel from Sam, INTC. You talked about the new video card business. It's been delayed twice. Now they're talking it up, but they're doing more marketing than actual production, and that's an issue. What you do like is that you've gotten at least back to this previous low, and that is the January 27th low, 52.66. You had 50 million shares. Yesterday, you had 22 million shares. You did break it. You haven't pulled really back into that trading range. You are about a dime above that low. Volume continues to be about the same. What you really didn't do that I would have liked would be after this April 12th high, you came back on light volume, and you really didn't. You went up on about the same energy as you came back down with in Intel. So none of these semis really are screaming that they need to be bought now. And staring down the barrel of earnings tonight. Be back in a minute.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at tfnn.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
And I continue to spend a lot of time looking at these ballistic stocks, waiting for them to crack, because just a 50% retracement on them, if you've got the puts, are going to be probably epic, probably a good way. No signs so far on Agilent. Nice gap higher today. Volume's okay, not near what it was yesterday, but we want to wait for the end of the day to see exactly what those are. Arch Capital, this one's getting awful close to the trend line. And not a, you know, just that it went up every day is more of an issue than being up $4 in the last 2 weeks. Some of the ones are getting a little closer, the ones that I was kind of scratching my head on, some of the things that make you go, hmm. And is on these grocery store companies. Everybody must think that they're all ready for some kind of buyout. I think that's highly optimistic. You did move higher back here on the big move of the 10th, but that's it. Warren's buying into them. That's the news. Okay. Well, you've gone nothing but sideways for the last 6 days. The question is whether or not you're going to get a pullback to that 25.50, which is, if you just look at the chart, where you would want to go. KRO, okay. ADP, this one had been kind of slowly moving higher. Today was when they dropped the chalupa. Fairly decent volume picking up for ADP. And again, these things are kind of like this. It is the last straw that tends to make these things, but they go sideways till they break it. Everybody kind of sees them moving into these moving averages, and then you generally get a pop. Doesn't mean it's the end of the world, but generally does mean the end of probably the easy times on trading it. Of course, a lot of people running for cover, and there's no better cover than most people look for than the utilities. Ameren, AEE is the symbol on this, has been going up fairly decently. You got no volume today on a little bit of down, but it's been going up since the 27th of July. No sign in that so far. Even today's just maybe a little bit of a hiccup. See what else we have here. Oh, KR, not KRO. Okay. American Financial Group, this has been on a tear since it had good earnings. It gapped up back on the 9th. You had a couple of days where it kind of went sideways and then started moving higher. Got kind of the same thing coming out here. Long-term double gaps are twice as likely, at least in my opinion, to get retested. So eventually, when this thing starts pulling back, 137 is going to bring you back to about 119. Aflac, not much going on that. It did tick a little bit below, but it's not as ballistic as some of the others. Let's see what else do you have out here. Microsystem, ALT, AM Core, Ameriprise. Aon is one that we've been talking about over the last few weeks. This one continues, just sideways today, but actually fairly good. Yesterday, about 1.7 million shares. Today, about 800,000 shares, just a little lower than the close. Not a big signal. But again, I suspect as these things start having problems going higher, they're going to hit those those 9-day moving averages or 3x3, which I like a little bit better because it seems to be a little bit more accurate for these when they do crack. It's going to hit these and then have a similar day as stocks that we've talked about before. Okay, APH, Amphenol. This is a connector company in the semi business. Still above, no signal on this one. It had a nice little reversal, really went above the trend line back on the 21st of July, hasn't really closed below it. The downside in this one is a little bit higher volume, higher price, and not much in the way of volume, but that's almost everything today. These water companies have been, we've talked about them for a few days. Aqua has been one of these, AQUA, he said. This one has kind of closed below, but it's trying to push. No volume in this one at all today, so watch for some sharp moves on that one. What else do we have here? American Waterworks, another one. This has been all over, but kind of formed a better trend line forward. Sometimes you just need to go to the next step higher to get the trend line. There's a 7x5 displaced moving average, but no real break of that, but a little bit more wiggly than some of the others. About half the volume of yesterday's doji. As we said, when those things start to turn and get underneath them, they tend to move fairly quickly. Let's see what else we have up here. BCE has had a nice little move higher. Not much volume here. You had a lot of volume more volume yesterday, and it went nowhere. BK, Bank of New York Mellon. They kind of topped out. Generally, if you don't break right away, then you're going to get one more stab at a high. And this would be the double repo patterns that I'm looking at. You've got exactly what you're looking for. You get 10 or 12, 15 days above. You come underneath it. You don't get a lot of reaction on the first one. Sometimes you get a little bit more. You pop back above it for a day, and then the next move down is generally where you start seeing the real action. So that may be a good one to start looking at. BlackRock's been up there. See what else we have up here. Costco, we've talked about that one a lot. Getting kind of close to the trend line higher. You've got the makings of what could be a doji here today. So we'll take a look at that. 455.23 on 1.2 million shares. So again, we'll see what the volume comes. Right now, you're probably not going to see a lot of difference until this thing breaks trend. When you do, it's probably going to be a rocket to 435 if it does turn right here. Datadog, another one that did well on earnings, but really has just been on a tear back to almost the May 6th low. Really, this thing's been going higher. You gapped up significantly on the August the 5th, but you've just kind of been going sideways here. Filling the gap would bring you back to 110 on it. Okay. Dover, just been going higher, like a lot of these ballistic stocks that I scan for. This thing's very, very close, though. Volume has really been decreasing since the last huge candle up on the 20th of July. You had a lot of volume there. That's probably where support comes in. So you got 174 today. probably back to about 163 is where that would find some. We'll be back in a minute.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV. Live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And as we finish up the day, we'll take a look. Yeah, we're off 14 points on the S&P cash, which is down about 0.3%. I suspect maybe at the last few minutes you might have some people buying and get kind of closer to unchanged on the day. NASDAQ's pretty much that, but we'll see. I am fairly bearish going into Friday, mostly because option market makers are extremely bearish. And, of course, on these SPYs, they've been kind of looking at a move back down to about 440. Is that right? Yeah. So you got a little bit of movement back down. Let's zoom in here a little bit. You got that's kind of the high part is about 440. So we'll see what's going on. Probably the best setup out here that you want to be looking at long term is the risk to the downside. And we have a beautiful confluence level right at 400 on this SPYs. That is exactly what you're looking for if you're doing Fibonacci And these things, when they're set up like this, when you have that very, very thin, maybe 1% or 0.5% bar between the 382 of one and the 618 of the other, that is pretty much as good as it's going to get. So if you were thinking the end of the world's hit, we're going to have a fairly deep pullback, generally you're going to look at that level as being, at least for the first time, incredibly good support in the market. So any risks that you're taking on now or thinking you're going higher, certainly you can't. On the downside, that's where that's going if we fail. We'll be back tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time. Remember to sell when you can, not when you have.
Building wealth.